if you found yourself not knowing where hope is, being afraid, feeling let down by life, I want you to know that you're not alone. Today I'm going to share with you some tools through scripture that I have found help me find hope again. So it comes out of Lamentations 3, verse 17. My soul is bereft of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. So I say, my endurance has perished. So has my hope from the Lord. Have you ever felt like you forgot what happiness is? I know that I have, and it has felt awful. It's awful to feel that way. It's awful to feel so depressed and anxious and not be able to go to sleep at night and not be able to get up in the morning. And here we have in Lamentations, the prophet who wrote Lamentations wrote, I have forgotten what happiness is. So if you felt that way, here's your proof in scripture that you're not alone. Verse 18 says, so I say my endurance has perished. So has my hope from the Lord. Now I dug into that one a little bit deeper and I looked up the original Hebrew in that. What really stuck out to me was the translation for my endurance has perished. The original Hebrew word for there means to wander away, to lose oneself, or to perish. So my strength, the word for endurance can also mean strength. My strength has wandered away to lose oneself. Have you felt like you lost yourself? That's what it means here, along with my hope from the Lord. Now the word for hope here actually means expectation. My strength has wandered away and my expectation in the Lord is gone. And I know when I've gone through tough times, I have felt like I can't expect good things anymore. And I felt like I don't know where hope is. That's where the song Dare to Hope Again was born out of. The first verse says, I've learned to live with heartache. I've learned to hide my pain. I've learned to build my walls so high just to get through the day. Somehow all this chaos has become a part of me. Did I lose myself? Can I still find a reason to believe? When I wrote that, I actually didn't know that this verse, that the Hebrew there actually means to lose yourself. Where it says my strength has perished. That's actually what the Hebrew means, but I didn't know that when I wrote that line. It's just how I felt. So did I lose myself? Can I still find a reason to believe? My endurance has perished, so is my hope from the Lord. And then in verse 19, the prophet talks about his specific, at least from what I understand, his specific struggles. Remember my affliction and my wanderings, the wormwood and the gall. So you can put in whatever you've dealt with. I can say, remember my brain injury and all the years of struggles that I've been through. Whatever you've gone through, that's what he's talking about. Verse 20 says, my soul continually remembers it and is bowed down within me. So the Hebrew there for bowed down actually means, according to Strong's Hebrew, to sink down. Have you ever just gotten bad news and felt like your heart just dropped to your toes and you just can't feel anything anymore, like you just empty out? That's what that means. Remembering the hard times, my soul sinks down within me. That's some deep emotion and that's what we go through. Verse 21, but this I call to mind and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. So I'm going to unpack that a little bit. The Hebrew there actually for the word mind actually means the heart, the feelings, the will, the intellect, the center. It means the center of your being, everything that you are. But this I call to the center of myself, and therefore I have hope. Now here's where it gets interesting. The word hope there is actually a different Hebrew word than the word for hope earlier in this chapter. In verse 18, when before it says, my hope from the Lord has perished. My expectation from the Lord, basically losing all expectations for anything good in life. That was gone. Now the next part, verse 21, uses a different word for hope. But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. Now this word for hope actually means to wait, to be patient, to hope. Now the definition of hope is all about expectation and expecting things. But I find it very interesting that there's a different Hebrew word in this part. Because that means that there are different types of hope. So you might lose hope from your situation and you might feel like there's no hope left. but you can gain a different kind of hope. And so verse 21, here's the key, but this I call to mind, therefore I have hope. I call to the center of my being. Verse 22, the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning, great is your faithfulness. The bridge between no hope and hope is reminding yourself of the truth that God loves you. Verse 24, the Lord is my portion, says my soul, therefore I will hope in him. The Hebrew word for hope used there in verse 24 is the same Hebrew word as verse 21. And so this new kind of hope can come out of calling to mind the love of God. So your circumstances might not change right away. Your situation might not change right away. But when you continue to have faith, faith bridges the gap. Faith is the evidence of things unseen. And when you call to mind the love of God and the character of God and who he is and what he has done, when you remind yourself all throughout this word, when you remind yourself of the goodness of God in every Bible story, the same God that parted the Red Sea is there for you. Jesus, who died on a cross and was raised in 3 days, came to life, and you are a new creation in the family of Christ because of Jesus. That's what we have to remind ourselves of. We have to remind ourselves of all of the miracles that God has done. And we have to remind ourselves of God's faithfulness that we've seen in our life, having a roof over our head, family, you know, for all the things that we struggle with and all the things that we lose, we have to learn how to find something to be grateful for. So no matter what your situation, no matter what you've dealt with, no matter what you're dealing with, know that sometimes your circumstance might not change right away, but our perspective can change. 2 Corinthians 4:18 says, so we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. Since what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. When we continually fix our eyes on God, on the author and perfecter of our faith, on the one who created us, who loves us more than anything in the whole world, if we fix our eyes on God and when we call the center of our being and remind ourselves of the mercy of God and the faithfulness of God and how his mercies are new every single morning, knowing that God is with you, he protects you, he goes before you and prepares the way. When we remind ourselves of who God is, really who God is, that's the bridge between no hope to hope. The tool that we have here from Lamentations 3, from no hope to hope, is calling to mind the love of God. So practically, that can look like opening your Bible, reading the Word of God. I always start with Psalms. It's a beautiful place. Of course, I'm a songwriter, so I am partial to the poetry there. But you can read the book of John. You can really read anything. Another thing you can do is put on a sermon, put on a YouTube video, put on some worship music. Do something to remind your soul, the center of your being, of who God is and of the love of God. Call a friend that you know is going to uplift you and encourage you and point you towards God. Do what you need to do to bring yourself into that place and remind yourself of who God is. And you will find hope again. It might be a different kind of hope. You might find a new version of hope that you never found before. Because when we go through trauma and when we go through tragedy, when you go through grief and loss, you might never have the same hope that you had before, but a different hope. Knowing that God is there and he gives us hope. He gives us faith in his love every day. His mercies are new every morning. We can find the love of God to sustain us, to build us up, to remind us of the greatness of God in our life, and to keep us going through hard times. Remember that if you're in Christ, you're a temple of the Holy Spirit, so you carry God with you wherever you go. Literally, the power that raised Jesus from the dead is in you at all times. And he's there to comfort you and build you up and remind you of his love. That's what the Holy Spirit does. And so tap into that and remind yourself of the power of God that is with you at all times. And know that the Holy Spirit of God can always bring you back to hope. So thanks for watching. This was just on my heart to share with you guys today. I hope it encouraged you, and remember that you can always choose hope again. Take the leap of faith, even when I'm